Yeah, I know you weren't expecting this, but here I is again, and I is going to turn down this radio because it's a little bit loud, but not too much because I like this song surprisingly. I just often have Triple J on, not for any particular reason, only because it's not really offensive and there's no ads, no fucking commercials. That's what I like about it. But then on the flip side, you got to think, well, if there's no commercials, then who's funding it? And obviously it's the funds that people already making money from, taxpayers, us. So in a way it is a commercial. I think I'll turn it off. Anyway, I can be fucked. I don't mind listening to this. Started off good, but now it's giving a shit. What isn't a commercial these days? What isn't? I mean, I can pretty much guarantee you that I'm not a commercial. The only thing I'm trying to sell, I don't even own. You know, if I could sell my soul to you, the devil, guess what? It's not mine to own. Not sold it. I freely gave it with all my heart and everything within me to God herself already. And you know that. And that is why you're just doing your ultimate to just put me down in every single way you possibly can. And that is why I keep floating. That is why. Because you know I defeated you. I was better than what you had to offer. And you're pissed off. Well, this is where everything starts to change for the better, for all of us. I put my life on the line and I gladly give it. I gladly give it. If you dare come and take it, come and get it. You know, you can't commit the same crime twice. Yeah, look, I'm sure there's plenty of you out there thinking, what the fuck am I on about? You haven't been through the shit I have been through, and you're probably thinking, I have this massive ego. I don't. My ego is crushed down into shells and nothing. I am nothing. I have nothing left to live for. I can't survive anymore. All because I tried to be a true man. Yes, I did. I took this bottle to my head and I pulled the trigger. I did that. I'm not making any excuses for that. I'm just being true to myself and doing what is right for me. Are you doing what is right for you, or what you think is your expectations from other people? That's what I'd like to know. Are you actually living true to yourself? Are you a true man or woman? Or are you just living up to other people's expectations? That's what makes this the True Man Show.
This track's called Extra Extra. I have really fond memories of playing this at the start of the year on the Swear Jar tour. You know, no one had heard the song. And
are you a true man?
And so I'd be playing it, and you know, by the
or you're living somebody else's fantasy. That's pretty much what it boils down to.
I'm really
hoping I get out of this matrix pretty soon, because I think I've pretty much fucking got to the end of it. I've nailed it. I've sorted it out. Ugh. The amount of times I thought I was close to reaching enlightenment, I did reach it at one point, but obviously I wasn't still ready to leave at that stage. Maybe I shouldn't. I had kids. My daughter was barely 2 years old. When I reached enlightenment, she saw me after I'd shaved my head. She didn't recognize me at all, and she freaked out. And that was cruel. That was a cruel thing to do to a 2 year old beautiful baby girl, Jessica. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry for everything. The whole path has been cruel to you as well as me. But I'm still your father. And I love you. And I'm so sorry. When you heard my voice, you came running back. And you were so glad. You were like, oh good, it's Dad again. It's Dad, yes. And then you saw my face. And you freaked out. You looked shaved. My head, and I think my face as well. It's okay. Change is what life is all about. I'll always love you, my daughter. Jessica. No matter what. This is the potential of love within me. Is I'll not just love you forever. Just because I'm your father. I love you. With all my being. And if I cannot show it, that's because that's just the way the world has been shaped. Around us. Yeah, I've got faults. I've got cracks.
In Detroit, and I saw a threat off Wyland Jeans, a
But can you not see the pleasure I get out of drinking this beautiful beer? If that's the biggest fault you see in me, it could be a fault you see in yourself, because I love it. And I feel it doing me good. In every cell and fiber of my being, and it helps me to survive. And if it makes me a bad person, does it? I mean, what bad things do I do other than react to the badness around me? You know, if you don't react to the badness around you, you're a bad person. You should react. You should get fucking angry. Pissed off to the point where all you've got left to do is just go and get fucking pissed. That's just it. And I know I've done a lot of that over the years, but never to the point where I got so pissed that, well, maybe there were sometimes I was that pissed. I wasn't myself. But most of the time I'm just doing this to try and stay sane and be a true man.
What sort of fashions on the field are you seeing at this private party right now?
That's all. That's all I'm doing. I don't expect anybody to forgive me for being who I am. I appreciate it if you do, but I don't expect it. Because from the depth of my being and my soul and who I am, I only ever come from a place of love. And that is why the devil never got my soul, because I voluntarily gave it to God. Long ago, he was sitting right by my side when I did it, and I had the most amazing out-of-body experience when something stepped in side of me and became not just me but more than me. You were right by my side, Jesse. And when I opened up my eyes, all I could do is look around and laugh and go, oh wow, I wear glasses now. And every bird around outside started singing. Every living thing was singing, sung the praise. Because I accepted that role. I said, yes, I will do it. I didn't do it for my ego, and I didn't do it for riches, and I didn't do it for fame. The last thing somebody like me ever wanted was fame. But I did it anyway. So now's the time. Now's the time. Now is the time to jump. Just jump into and accept I don't. I know most of you won't accept. You think I haven't been through this a million times already in my own head? I know that you won't accept. That you're going to put me to the test a million times over, and I'm just going to have to answer a million times questions. You could just accept. I am not the Antichrist. I'm just a beer drinking, bong smoking Aussie bastard. Actually, I'm not a bastard. My parents are married. And my parents are beautiful people. Would you actually accept it, though, when you came face to face with Christ? Would you accept it, or would you reject it? Because I tell you truly, you have that choice. To accept it or reject it. And it is up to you. And I 100% am here for you. No miracles. Life itself is a miracle. Our existence is a miracle. Don't ask for miracles, because yeah, the first thought that came into my head then is I will fucking cane you. But I restrained myself for a few moments. Your existence is a miracle. Our entire existence is the miracle already. Good night. Our next step is to enhance our existence and make it heaven on earth. That's what we're here to do. Make heaven on earth. So, waiting for outside intervention? No. We are the intervention. All we're going to do is intervene with the one who wants your soul. Yeah. The devil wants your soul. He wants to sell you on lies and lies and lies. That's why we have this whole heliocentric model, because he's been selling you on these lies all this time and enslaving you for his profit. Well, no more profit to the devil. I mean, that's just a generic term for who he really is, but he knows. He's looked into my eyes, and he was afraid. And this was before I accepted this role. So, I don't know, I don't want to come across as a religious nutter or a freak or somebody with this big ego who thinks they're more than they are. All I am is me, is myself. I'm humble, very humble, almost destroyed man. But inside. In here. I have hope for all humanity, and I will give it to you because I have the answers in here. And I will. Free energy, free food, free housing, free abundance for everybody. And the end of these fucking selfish fucking bastards sucking all the life out of all of us. But I do need your help. I can't do it on my own. You know, you're just going to watch me sink into the ground in my current situation unless you find some way of helping me to help you, because that's all I want to do. And I will. I will. I will bring this world into a sort of abundance that you've never seen before. If you look through my YouTube videos, and I've made heaps and heaps and freaking heaps of them, you will see I have answers and answers and answers. And even most of them, even if they never come to anything, don't mean shit, because, hello, we can still grow hemp and replace oil overnight like that and stop fucking destroying and polluting this beautiful world. Hemp. Simple as that. Simple as that. And I like to keep things simple. No complicated bullshit saying billions and billions of miles and billions of years that make everything true. What is true is what you see is what you get. You don't see curvature of the earth. You don't see billions and billions of years of evolution that turn other species into anything. What you see is what you get. I'm on your side. I'm asking nothing from you. I'm not trying to tax you or make you a slave in my system. I want to give you freedom. True freedom like you've never seen before. And we will see humanity blossom like we've never seen it before. That is my life mission. Ancients@hotmail.com. I'm the ancient one. Ancients@hotmail.com through PayPal. Just by putting in 20 or 30 or 50 or whatever amount of dollars you have, I will fix this world. I will. I promise. And I don't break promises.